Modoc Mountains, Cedar Pass. Beautiful forest. Really makes me want to camp somewhere in here. It'd be a really short day though. Almost up there. I did it! Cedar Pass.
Okay. Feeling pretty good. I pedaled up to Cedar Pass. Was about a 1500 foot climb. Not too serious. About 5 miles. And guess what? That's it for the day. We're gonna stay right here. Somewhere near here. Modoc National Forest. I just sat with my maps for a good 15 minutes. I'm kind of piecing the pages together because it's not my original plan to take Highway 395 into Reno. But as it sits now, that's my only choice, unless I hitchhike. Actually, this whole time before I got to this pass, I thought I would be begging for a ride down at the bottom, and I just put it in low gear, 4 miles an hour, and just huffed it right up. And so I pieced together the maps and the distances, and I'm very content knowing I only have 200 miles to get to Reno. And I'm charting out camp spots, water locations, probably a motel room. I don't know how that's gonna work. It's logistically, the best plan would be to get a motel room in Reno so that the following morning I could pedal to the bus stop. I don't think the bus is gonna get there until like 1 or 2 o'clock, but I don't care if I have to wait for it. And the fact is, 200 miles divided by 50 is only 4 days. So I pretty much have in my mind 7 days to get to Reno. And so we're just gonna lounge here. Maybe explore. There's some really cool rock formations, lava formations up here. I might take a short venture up here, check it out.
See an easier way over there. I'd like to get there to that draw and have a view west.
This is super cool up here. Tons of hiding places. And I did see a cat turd down there by the bike. And I'm sure this is also bear country. I'm up here, real nice, tough workout, pretty steep, like a 60 degree slope over here. I came up here for a view of Mount Shasta. I thought it would be closer, but I'll show you what I got. And the clouds are close. And there's a grouse over here. Whoomp, whoomp. And here's the fact. This is the pinnacle of this bicycle trip. Right here. It's the farthest north that I'm going, and it's the highest I'll be. It's great. I'm glad I came up here. Okay, it's the morning of day number 8. I feel great. I feel well rested. I feel energized. And I'm ready for a big day. It was quite cold here last night, as I expected. The ground was cold. I put my extra plastic bags under my sleeping pad, my pants, socks, underwear, to try to buffer myself from the cold. It worked a little bit. I got the rest I needed. It was fine. I have a good routine. It seems it takes a little while to get into the routine that works best. My morning breakfast is a power bar, which is appetizing and filling, along with my coffee. Today the beginning is all downhill, probably 10 miles. I'm going to skirt Alturas, heading south. And hopefully I'll be able to find out about services at the cities that I hope to find water. I suppose that's it. Time to start heading home.
Thank you. heading towards Alturas, and I just got some information that I've got a long, dry stretch. Maybe two nights from Likely to Litchfield, which is near Susanville. Highway 395.
Well, it was a great day of pedaling. I didn't really check in with this camera. From Cedar Pass, it was kind of downhill and then rolling through some really pretty, I don't know, upper desert, lower mountain area, trees, green meadows, ranches. I took a side route, 58, County Road 58, and then to 56, then it connected into to Alturas. It was mostly all downhill, quite a bit of mileage, and there at the intersection of 395 was a city park where I cleaned the bike, had a break, and then hit the main highway, 395. More traffic, nothing real serious yet with the shoulder that I was able to use. And the thing about that is, if I stay far over in the shoulder, the cars don't move, and it's close to my comfort zone, so I kind of edge a little bit over to the white line. And I'm wearing my rear view mirror here, and if I see them not moving over, I kind of give them shit to move over, right? So far it was all good. From Alturas, my guess is from Cedar Pass to Alturas was about 20-25. From Alturas north on 395 to Likely was about 18 to 20 miles. Easy going. A lot of it was downhill, mellow grade downhill. And then at Likely, there was a grocery store. I stocked up full with water. The lady was great. I was hoping there was a restaurant there. I would have ordered a hamburger and some French fries. I'm dying for some fried potatoes. And so I pedaled up to this pass, which Likely Mountain is up here, and there's an access road right over here for the radio towers. Right here is just an amazing stroke of luck. There's some slowly flowing water, and it's not really mucky or dirty. I can see that more has flowed through here, but had I known, I wouldn't have carried so much water. It was only about 8 miles, slightly uphill to this point, but this is great. Now I can hydrate, and then I'll need to be fully loaded again when I take off down the next stretch towards Litchfield. 65 miles, give or take, from here, and I'm going to camp in between here and there because it's more habitated with people and houses and stuff, and stealth camping chances really greatly diminished. I saw a park ranger come through here, real nice guy. He told me it was cool to camp here, so I'm golden. Great peace of mind right here with the water and these trees. Just fabulous forest here. From Likely, the sky just filled up with this gray, and so not really menacing yet. There was a nice breeze kind of propelling me along up to this pass. So we might get some rain. I see that the clouds are a little thicker down south, but I'm ready. I'm hoping this will stay dry here. Probably will with this drainage here, but it's really hard to know when a lot of water comes down where the little runnels are. Look, you can see one right here, and it comes right by the corner of my tent, maybe around from this way. I mean, when you are setting up, you got to think of that, where if it's going to rain, where that water is going to go. So in this case, just imagine it could be coming right through here, and just the corner would get wet, which wouldn't bother me. It's a great day to be in the bicycling groove.
I'm out wandering around near Likely Mountain, and I've noticed some of these, just big collection of bark. And I just wonder if some animal is putting all that there for a den or something. Really weird. Well, here's a sun break. Beautiful forest. This is sublime for me, this sanctuary here. And look how dark it is there. Well, that's where I was. I'm glad I'm not over there.
So I took a walk up the road, and I could see that this small creek had washed out the road recently. And so I'm looking at how high this water was, and in some places it was about 12 to 18 inches higher than the level of it now. And so then I'm looking here above my campsite, and I can see right here it flowed over the creek bed, flowed right down this way. The ground is still damp here. It's still damp here, and it flowed right through here. This is damp, damp, damp. It wasn't that long ago, and so it just comes right through here. It must, from up here. So with these big black clouds over here, and it's almost like still, there's no wind. If some of these big clouds open up and just sit up here, I'm gonna be screwed. I've got a place just up here, and I'm really thinking of relocating, even though this is a really nice place. I'm really thinking about it right now. Okay, sun feels good. This is day 10, and we're counting down now, the days left. I'm thinking there's 4 days left, roughly 160 miles to Reno, and I've charted the days to coincide with arriving Sunday night there. Get a motel, get up Monday morning, and get to the bus stop. And that's assuming everything goes as planned. And I sort of realized that I had to kind of slow it down a little bit, but not much. For instance, yesterday was 40 miles, given the next 4 days, would be 40 miles each a day. And that's good enough for me. The rain, those big clouds, were mostly menacing. It just sprinkled for maybe 5 minutes last night. I did move the tent. Couple concerns with the rest of the trip is, first of all, getting done early in the day. For instance, it was 3:30 yesterday. If it's a warm, sunny day and there's no shade, I have to, you know, just kind of bear in the sun, trying to stay cool, relax, and it's not easy. So I'm hoping that there's going to be some shade. This first night tonight is going to be a difficult one with no shade. And the following nights, I'm going to be dealing with populated areas. And the stealth camping is going to be tricky. There's the continuing issue with chafing on my left butt cheek. Almost like a pimple or ingrown hair, but in various places. And what I realized is that sleeping in with these long johns, which is almost a must, it's chilly, it gets hot and sweaty in that area in my sleeping bag every night. It's kind of a bummer. Even with baby powder, I use hand sanitizer to clean down there. It's just a daily sort of nasty ritual. It's just part of the adventure. So the other thing I realize is that I have to change Band-Aids frequently to keep that area clean. And yesterday, for instance, it was hard to get that last 8 or 10 miles because it really hurt, and it's demoralizing. Just that little tiny thing can make this whole body want to stop.
Flowing water here in this pass. Squaw Hen Pass, maybe? No, Sage Hen.
Okay, this is gonna be where I'm camping, right here. Right at the edge of the fence line for Highway 395. Real nice, it pulled back from the highway a good maybe 80 yards, something like that. So anyway, kind of reminiscent of my first and second touring trip camping next to the highway. Real nice surprise to see these trees here. I thought I would be all in the sage desert, and there was a slight climb, and this is probably the last chance for trees before Litchfield. So there it is. I got 37 miles, which I wanted to get 40, but this is good. I'm gonna take it. Okay, here's my zone. I'm set up. It was a breezy day, and this is one thing I've realized traveling in these big open places, and you know, not just this trip, but my last trip too, is that the wind funnels through these geological formations, the mountains, the buttes, the valleys, the lakes. For instance, today when I came down from that pass, the wind was in my favor, and the whole bottom lake there, I was just cruising right along, 15, 16 miles an hour. And that's great. That's just like bicycling nirvana with all the touring gear. And then as I came over and came into the next lake bed, the wind was in my face, and it was hard. It was harsh. And then I kept hoping that it would change as I bent it around to come up in this area, and it did. It started coming from behind again. You know, there are times when it always comes from one direction, but my experience is that it comes from everywhere and it varies. Yeah, we're just chilling here. I had a kind of a cozy nap, but sprinkled a little bit. And the breeze is cool. I'm surprised. Okay. Friday morning, day number 11. This was my zone. Slept well enough, and trucks woke me up at the crack of light. It's not even dawn, but the break of day. It was a cold night. It's chilly now. The wind is starting to pick up, and now it's coming from the south. Last night it was coming from the north. This is my direction, and it's gonna slow me down and probably make me a little cold. We're again just kind of milking the rest of these next 3 days to get to Reno. We'll see how it goes. I'm curious to see what services are down here. Stitchfield, I think, is the next town, 20 some miles out.
I was sitting right here, and I found this geocaching game piece right down there. Runny Lake is down there. I'll be pedaling on the other side of that tomorrow. Susanville is over this way. Susanville, I decided to come this way. The wind is just nudging me right along. Barely any effort at all. Thank you.
This is Susanville. I decided to get a motel room here. I'm at 45 miles, which is good. The wind just kept pushing me right along. It's my vacation and I wanted to have another motel room and shower up, watch some cable TV. You know how that goes. 14,000 people here. I don't know where they all are. Up in the hills maybe, spread out. And the old town is just kind of decaying. It's a little sad. They couldn't keep it alive. Seems like they're trying. Tons of motels here, falling apart. And then you've got the 2000 sprawl heading out, General Dollar, dollar store, food for less, etc. This mural is real nice here. I think maybe the entire population is just driving up and down this main street. There's so much traffic. It's hard to believe.
Another nice one. Is that? Good old Dad Popcorn.
There we go.
Okay. Hi, I'm Kurt. Here's Kurt.
I'm Kurt.
Yeah, hi Kurt. Well, I'm Fitz, and I used to live in Bishop, where Kurt lives, and I used to do the Everest Challenge and some of the local races around there. And I live in Susanville now, and enjoying it, and still get out on the road and ride. And it's been a pleasure meeting Kurt.
What was the group that you were with?
Oh yeah, I belong to the Goathead Velo. I don't know whether it's they still have that bicycle racing club now, but that used to be the bike club they had there. I still have their jerseys and everything.
Oh, cool. So, what year was that?
Oh, let me see. It was about 20 years ago.
All right.
I forget the name of the bike shop in there. I think Brian is his name. He's
Arrowhead?
Arrowhead Bikes.
Well, yeah. You know what? He just sold that.
Oh, he did?
Yeah,
oh.
There's a new guy, Chris, in there now.
Oh.
Real nice guy.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, I knew him real well.
Yeah, I met him actually just when I first got there.
Oh, really? Is that right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's interesting. I was going to... I get down to Bishop every once in a while. I do a lot of climbing in the mountains and so forth. And I was going to stop by and see him, but I guess he's not there. Well, here it is. It's time to sell. Anyway, but he did a good business here. I actually bought my bike from him.
This one right here?
Not this. Well, I bought this one from him.
Let's see. What are you riding?
Well, this is a mountain bike. MB3 Bridgestone.
This is about, 20 years old?
Yeah, about 20 years old. It's a steel bike. It's a real workhorse. I use it for commuting, and I do some local mountain biking up here in the hills. It's
good,
great.
Good this trails
is,
here?
Oh, yeah. This is a great place for trails. If you have a chance, the Biz Johnson Trail is where you go down, let's see, you go down here to Weatherlow and turn to the left, and there's a old train station there, and the Biz Johnson Trail follows the old railway.
Oh, nice.
And
nice.
It goes all the way to Westwood. It was about 35 miles.
Well, I've been wanting to come to Susanville for a long time.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Thank you, Fritz.
Oh, okay, you bet.
Keep the rubber down.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We'll do that. Okay.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Rivers, rewards, birds of gallant
It's the next day, Saturday, day 12, I think. I had a great time in Susanville yesterday. Crappy night at the motel room. People next door got up again at 5, something like that. Just a horrible night's rest. And now I'm on the busy highway, 395, going into Reno. I've got 2 days. Tomorrow afternoon I'll get there, get a motel room. Kind of feeling it though, I'm a little tired today. We'll do it, we'll get it. That's about it.
This is Honey Lake over here, and soon I'll be past it.
That's a dust devil, a black one. That's pretty gnarly, that dust devil. I mean, that's a... I've never seen one that big. And what's crazy is when I was coming into this valley from the north, I thought there were industrial fires. They're burning like nasty stuff, making black smoke. But it's actually these dust devils just getting bigger. All right, this is my last night of camping, and it was just a crap shot to get up here. I'm right above the highway 395. It drops down right here, and it's over here, and I had to take like 4 trips to get all my stuff up here. My bicycle is locked up to the fence over here, and yes, the fence is far away from the highway, and down low, no one can see me. I've got the beginning of a shade from the sagebrush here, maybe nearly 50 miles today. It got warm. And this was almost out of desperation, but it's gonna work. What's interesting is because the highway is tucked down over this rise, the sound is muffled. Like I start to hear them coming this way, and I can hear them coming from this way, and they could, these people could probably see me right now, even like with this bright hat, but they'd have to be looking, like scanning over here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna be all right. It's been a real challenge here in this sun. I draped some clothing here to block the sun. Quite hot, very thirsty, long day. My arms blistered from sunburn, but they were already tanned, but they blistered again. I'm looking forward to going home. It was a long trip. 410 miles so far. Couldn't really sleep here with the traffic. I'm tired, real tired. I'll sleep good tonight, but then probably have an early morning. And soon I'll be able to cook dinner. Well, this is where I spent the night. And yes, I'm well rested, even though the highway's right here. Was quite interesting last night, just after sunset. I put my earplugs in and I thought I heard some hooting. And I took them out, and still there was lots of traffic, but there was an owl hooting, which was really kind of hard to believe, because there's no trees really close here. There's just a couple down by the road. And so, again, it's my totem. The owl, it gives me courage. It gives me direction, and I told it that I loved it, and then it stopped. Interestingly also, which I forgot to mention, is at the motel there was a huge, maybe a ponderosa tree, evergreen tree, big one back there by my room, and there was an owl going crazy in that tree all night. And when the neighbors started making noise, I turned my light on to find my earplugs. The owl stopped hooting. Like, he saw my light come on. And that was that. Just crazy happenings. Today's the last day of riding. I've got 3 band-aids on my butt cheek. This one spot always flares up. Debilitating. And we're going to Reno today. I guess I'm done with the highway. This is the Red Rock exit. And there was a sign saying bicycles must exit. 395. Wasn't too bad. There was a hill to climb that was kind of stinky with exhaust. And this here is Virginia Avenue, which eventually connects to Main Street. Fact is, there was a huge lane for me on the freeway, like a 10-foot lane. It was probably safer there than on this back road. Almost there. Thank you. waiting for the bus to get back to Bishop. I got here 3 hours early, and that's what you have to do to get your bus, get to the right spot. Hell, I could have had a flat tire on the way here and missed the bus. It's not so now. 2 weeks, 450 miles on that. No breakdowns. And now I'll mention the greatest luck with the wind. I wasn't going to mention it because I was afraid if I did, it would pick up and blast me in the face. Going into Susanville, I was carried right along. If I had pedaled against that wind, it would have stopped me. So the wind died down when I left Susanville, which was great. Basically, almost the whole way into Reno, the wind was in my favor. Either it was pushing me along or it was non-existent. That's that.